for zero.
Don't be shy. Just like we used to. Come on. Keep up. Sorry. Did I wake you up? Today's Mommy's birthday. On the anniversary of when we first met.
This is a somewhat unusual order. You're going to want to review the key points in the summary. Thank you.
That's a breathable container, remember? For its passengers' sake, don't immerse it in water.
Order assigned. Delivery parameters updated. Time limit set. Beginning scan. Have a pleasant journey.
Mm-hmm.
center.
Okay.
Deliver your cargo, then you can take on new requests.
Welcome back, Sam Bridges. Always a pleasure. Thanks for the delivery. That was crazy fast. You've really upped your game since last time. The cryptobiotes look nice and lively.
Hey, I got something for you. Okay, safe travels. There's something different about you. Can't quite put my finger on what, but I swear, I'm not imagining.
I'm impressed, Sam. You've brought pretty much the entire region together. But the further west you head, the more you're going to have to deal with BTs. Now, we're always looking for new, more permanent solutions. And we know your blood has a measurable effect on them. I told you before that Mama's developing a weapon to leverage that. Which is why we need a way to artificially produce more of it. Hence the cryptobiotes. But maybe you already figured it out. If all goes according to plan, we might be able to turn the tide. But first, it's time to bring Portnoy City into the UCA. The order from Die Hartman is waiting on the delivery terminal.
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information.
Sam, I received word from Mama that she's completed her anti-BT weapon. Prototypes of her design form a part of your next shipment. A delivery of relief supplies for the people of Portnoy City. Portnoy City's a fair distance from BT territory, but the weapons should come in handy if any stray too close. They'll also provide people with the means to defend themselves when traveling outside the city limits. The shipment also includes a variety of medicines, as well as human sperm and egg samples. These specimens are essential for maintaining genetic diversity as they were donated by civilians living outside the major population centers. By taking advantage of Kyrellium's temporal properties, We can ensure they remain viable for as long as required. After the shipment's been processed, connect the Cupid. Now, once that's done, the entire region will be integrated into the chiral network. Afterwards, you'll be pushing on to Lake Knot City. So we've included relief supplies for the people there as well. Of course, to get there, you'll need to cross over the lake in between. Details on that will be in a second order you'll need to accept then. Without a doubt, this will be your longest run for us to date. Make sure you've got everything you need.
Sam. That's a transfusion bag containing blood drawn from you. While equipped, it'll gradually replenish yours.
Sam, this is our first attempt at developing an anti-BT weapon. I had to work fast with what we had, so they're basically modified hand grenades. At least, that's how they're meant to function. They've never actually been tested in the field. Who knows? You might be the first person to kill a BT. And wouldn't that be something? But, even if they do work, don't forget that they're fueled by your blood. Use too much, and you'll give yourself anemia. Sam, up for performing an experiment with hematic grenade? Might be worth taking a look.
Keep on keeping on.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Sam, having dooms gives you advantages most folks don't have. But as capable as you are, you're also a member of Bridges now. An organization filled with experts in a whole variety of fields, all of whom are ready and willing to help. The team is here for you, Sam. All you have to do is ask. Got it? Good.
name's Sam. Sam.
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges. Restrictions lifted.
Sam, it's Hartman. Your friend and fellow doom sufferer. Our affliction, such as it is, began with the beach, or rather, our discovery of it. Once, the question of life after death was answered only by religion and philosophy. When we learned of the beach's existence, death became something more tangible, knowable. The living soon walked the shores of the afterlife, while dead things, beached things, began to find their way back. And then came Dooms, and with it a host of theories advanced by physicians and psychologists, desperate to explain the world's newest mystery. The symptoms were duly categorized and stratified into levels. But repatriates like you are a singularly rare breed, worthy of a classification all your own. The specialists must have been climbing over one another to get a look at you.